system may have been a probe sent by an advanced alien civilization. Astronomers were excited to discover the interstellar object last year. It was named Oumuamua.
It turns out that C-2017 U-1 Pan-STARRS, later given the Hawaiian name Oumuamua.
Just now, the James Webb Space Telescope took a scary photo of Oumuamua, the first known object from another star system to visit us. Oumuamua is very long and thin, much more than any normal space rock. Some scientists even wonder if it could be alien technology because of its strange shape and the weird way it speeds up. Tune in as we dive into this mystery and see what Oumuamua might tell us about the far reaches of space. Unveiling cosmic secrets. Oumuamua's discovery in 2017 by the Pan-STARRS Observatory has ignited widespread debate among scientists due to its odd characteristics. Its unique properties have challenged conventional scientific thought, sparking intense discussions. The biggest mystery remains its origin. Although it approached from the Lyra constellation, its exact star system remains unknown. Stay tuned as we uncover where Oumuamua came from, a mystery that could change how we see the universe. One reason for the mystery is Oumuamua's incredible speed as it passed by the sun. It's so fast that it's almost certain it didn't come from our solar system, and it may have been traveling through space for millions or even billions of years. Since the stars it might have passed by have moved over time, figuring out its origin has become a real puzzle for scientists. Oumuamua's path through space was also strange. It approached from above the plane where most planets and objects orbit, meaning it didn't get near any major planets. This made its journey even harder to understand. Scientists are now using data from the Gaia spacecraft to try and trace its path backward, but its exact origin remains a mystery. When it comes to its shape, scientists don't have a clear picture. Artistic drawings exist, but we know it's about 10 times longer than it is wide, which is highly unusual. It also spins very quickly, which makes its brightness change dramatically as it moves through space. This rapid spinning made Oumuamua seem to flicker as it passed Beatty. Another strange thing was how Oumuamua sped up as it got closer to the sun. Normally, we would expect this from something like a comet, which releases gas and dust when it gets warm. But scientists didn't see any signs of this happening with Oumuamua. Some have suggested that this could be due to other things, like gas jets, or the melting of unusual materials like hydrogen or nitrogen ice. But nothing has been proven yet. Despite the brief time it's spent in our solar system, Oumuamua is now moving away at about 26 kilometers per second. It will leave our solar system completely in about 20,000 years, which is very quick in the grand scheme of the galaxy. This fleeting encounter, along with its speed, makes it tough for scientists to study it further. Some scientists think Oumuamua could be a fragment of a larger object, possibly a planet or moon, that got knocked out of its original star system by another star. If that's true, it may have been wandering through space for a very long time before it entered our solar system. Others think it could have broken apart near a star, which might explain its unusual shape. One of the most intriguing ideas comes from astrophysicist Avi Loeb, who has suggested that Oumuamua could be something more extraordinary, possibly a piece of alien technology. He believes that its odd shape and unexpected behavior might make more sense if it's artificial, like a solar sail or even part of a massive structure designed to capture energy from a star. If this idea were true, it would completely change how we think about objects in space. Oumuamua's mystery continues to capture the attention of scientists around the world. As they dig deeper into this strange object, more questions arise about what it's made of, how it was formed, and whether it could even be a piece of technology. If we find that Oumuamua is unlike anything we've seen before, it could point to something truly remarkable. Ongoing research and future missions might help us solve the puzzle, whether it turns out to be a weird asteroid or something far more surprising. Miniature spacecraft could soon give us a closer look at Oumuamua. These tiny probes could reach the object within a few years and provide valuable information about its location and features. Even if they only manage to pinpoint where Oumuamua is now, they could still send back important data. For example, they could help us figure out if it's still speeding up due to forces other than gravity. This information would be crucial for planning more detailed missions to study Oumuamua further. Sending a larger mission to investigate Oumuamua would be a major undertaking, possibly as expensive as NASA's New Horizons mission, which explored Pluto and is now in the Kuiper Belt. This kind of project could cost around $1 billion. Convincing people to fund such a mission might be tough, since there's no guarantee that it will uncover anything extraordinary. Still, many scientists remain hopeful that future opportunities will arise. One promising mission is the European Space Agency's Comet Interceptor, which is set to launch in 2029. This fully funded mission will send a large spacecraft and two smaller probes to a special point in space where they'll wait for a new interstellar object or a fresh comet from the outer reaches of our solar system. During the mission, it will collect images, spectra, and other data, providing insight into objects like Oumuamua. The Comet Interceptor will be equipped with three cameras, one on the main spacecraft and one on each of the smaller probes, to take three-dimensional images of its target. It will also use infrared imaging and a mass spectrometer to analyze any gases coming from the object. The main spacecraft will pass within about 1,000 kilometers of the target, while the smaller probes will get even closer, at distances of about 800 and 400 kilometers. This mission, which will have up to 5 years to find and study a suitable object, is an exciting chance to learn more about interstellar visitors. Observing interstellar objects like Oumuamua and Comet Borisov helps us gather valuable scientific insights by comparing them, unlocking the mystery of Oumuamua. But here's the big question. What is Oumuamua made of, and where did it come from? Its long, cylinder-like shape might hold clues. Some people even think it could be artificial, perhaps a spacecraft or some other kind of advanced technology, due to its unusual brightness changes. To get answers, we need a more detailed study, especially if there's any chance it could be an object created by intelligent life. However, reaching Oumuamua is a huge challenge because of its speed, about 20 kilometers per second. Our current rockets aren't fast enough, but gravity assist techniques, which use the gravity of planets to speed up a spacecraft, could help. Adam Hibbard, a software engineer from the United Kingdom, has been working on figuring out the best paths for spacecraft to reach Oumuamua. He joined Project Lyra, a team that's focused on developing possible flight plans to reach the object. One idea they're considering is a mission that could start in 2030 and would take about 22 years to get to Oumuamua. However, this timeline is pretty long, so Hibbard and his team looked into different routes that use Jupiter's gravity instead of the Sun's. These new paths, which involve several gravity assists from planets like Earth and Venus, would take about 31 years but offer a better chance of success than Sun-based approaches. Even if we can plan the perfect route, a mission like this would need a big spacecraft, similar to NASA's New Horizons. And at a cost of about $1 billion, there's always the risk of either missing Oumuamua or finding out that it's just a regular rock. There's another interesting idea called a von Neumann probe, named after the mathematician John von Neumann. These probes could potentially replicate themselves using materials they find in space, allowing them to travel and explore far beyond what humans can do. They could even prepare planets for future exploration. However, we've never observed any of these self-replicating probes, which raises questions about whether advanced civilizations would ever build them or if they're even possible. Despite the challenges and uncertainties, the mystery of Oumuamua continues to spark curiosity. Whether it's an ordinary rock or something much more exciting, the search for answers is far from over. The idea of a super void, a region of space billions of light years wide, has been suggested as a possible explanation for the Hubble tension, which is the disagreement between different methods of measuring the universe's expansion rate. A super void could affect how we perceive galaxies' movement, making them appear to be receding faster than they actually are from our point of view on Earth. This is just one of several ideas being considered to explain why there are differences in how we measure the universe's growth. Advanced civilizations, if they exist, might send out detectable signals like radio transmissions. However, despite years of searching, we haven't received any clear signals from alien civilizations, raising questions about whether they exist or, if they do, why they aren't communicating with us. One key factor in detecting such civilizations is how long they last. Those that survive for long periods are more likely to be found, while those that quickly self-destruct are much harder to detect. The search for extraterrestrial intelligence has used various methods to search for signals from advanced civilizations, such as using large radio telescopes like the Very Large Array and the Green Bank Telescope. Even though decades of research have not yet found conclusive evidence of alien life, advances in technology could increase our chances of making a discovery in the future. New stars are expected to continue forming for many trillions of years, which means life could emerge in new places far into the future. According to some predictions, star formation could support life for up to 100 quadrillion years, even as galaxies slowly drift out of view due to gravitational changes over time. Despite the vast size of the universe, the quest to find life beyond Earth remains an exciting challenge. Earth is the only place we know for sure where life exists, planets where life has developed. Several planets outside our solar system, known as exoplanets, have been identified as potential places where life might exist or where humans could settle. One of the most promising is Kepler-186f, which was discovered in April of 2014 and is located about 490 light years from Earth. This planet is only about 10% larger than Earth and sits in its star's habitable zone, where conditions might allow liquid water to exist. Getting to Kepler-186f with our current technology would take hundreds of millions of years, but finding planets like it brings us a step closer in the search for places that could support life. Another interesting planet is Kepler-283c, which is almost twice the size of Earth and orbits much closer to its star than Earth does to the Sun. This planet, found over 1,700 light years away, is also in the habitable zone and could potentially support Earth-like life. Closer to home, the JJ-667 system, just over 22 light years away, includes planets that orbit in their star's habitable zone. These planets, JJ-667cc and JJ-667ce, offer the unusual possibility of seeing three suns from their surfaces. Although they are relatively close by cosmic standards, visiting these planets is still a huge challenge. Yet they provide a glimpse into what different kinds of habitats might exist beyond our solar system. NASA's Kepler Space Telescope has also uncovered fascinating planets such as Kepler-62e and Kepler-62f, which are located about 100 light years away in the Lyra constellation. These planets could be water worlds entirely covered by oceans. Kepler-62e is about 1.6 times the size of Earth, and Kepler-62f is around 1.4 times larger, both orbiting a red dwarf star. If they are indeed covered in water, they could host marine life or other forms of life we haven't yet imagined. A closer look at life's potential beyond Earth. Another notable planet is JJ-581d, about 20 light years from Earth. This planet might have a thick carbon dioxide atmosphere, making it difficult for humans to survive without oxygen. Still, it could have liquid water and possibly even lush rainforests or other unique ecosystems. The James Webb Space Telescope, which launched in late 2021, is leading the way in exploring exoplanets and their potential for life. It is currently studying the TRAPPIST-1 system, which contains seven Earth-sized planets, three of which are located in the habitable zone of their star. This telescope represents a major leap forward in our ability to study distant planets and brings us closer to understanding whether life exists beyond Earth. Mercury moves incredibly fast through space, at about 48 kilometers per second, which plays a big role in shaping its unique characteristics. This rapid movement creates strong gravitational effects that could influence how the planet's insides behave and even affect its surface features. Being so close to the Sun also means Mercury gets hit by intense solar winds and radiation, which can strip away lighter materials and change its geology and atmosphere. Despite these extreme conditions, Mercury's surface shows signs of a much more active past. Recent spacecraft images have revealed evidence of volcanic activity and tectonic movements. Lava flows on the surface suggest that Mercury wasn't always just a cold, cratered rock. It was once volcanically active, which challenges the old idea of Mercury as an inactive world. Scientists have found water ice in craters near Mercury's poles, where the Sun never reaches. These ice deposits have been protected from the Sun's heat and might hold clues about how water and other important substances were delivered to the inner solar system. By studying this ice, scientists could learn more about how Earth became capable of supporting life. Mercury's magnetic field is another mystery. It's much weaker than Earth's, but the fact that it exists at all suggests that the planet still has some activity in its core. This could mean that Mercury once had a more dynamic, molten interior. The presence of this magnetic field, especially on such a small planet, points to a complex and interesting history of the planet's evolution. Exploring Mercury helps scientists understand how rocky planets like Earth form and change over time. Mercury's harsh environment and unique features show how different planets can turn out, depending on their surroundings. It also forces scientists to rethink some of the existing ideas about how planets form and evolve. Mercury's atmosphere is extremely thin, made up of oxygen, sodium, hydrogen, helium, and potassium. It's constantly being replenished by solar radiation and tiny meteoroid impacts. Studying this delicate atmosphere gives scientists a chance to see how a planet's surface interacts with the solar wind, offering insights into similar processes on other planets. To study Mercury, scientists use special instruments like spectrometers and magnetometers on spacecraft that orbit the planet. These tools measure the elements and minerals on Mercury's surface and map out the features. By doing this, scientists can better understand the planet's geology, including the age and formation of different regions. In many ways, Mercury acts as a natural testing ground for planetary science theories. It helps us understand how planets in our solar system and beyond form and evolve. The strange and intriguing features of Mercury not only raise big scientific questions, but also broaden our knowledge of planets throughout the universe. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, is set to expand our knowledge of the universe with its incredible ability to see in infrared light. Unlike regular telescopes that capture visible light, JWST can look through thick clouds of cosmic dust and weigh, uncovering things that were previously hidden from view. This makes it a powerful tool for studying the early universe, where young galaxies and quasars, very bright objects powered by black holes, are only visible in infrared light because their light has stretched over time as the universe expands. JWST's large mirror, made of 18 hexagonal segments coated with gold, helps it gather light very efficiently, allowing it to detect faint objects that are far away. This mirror design lets the telescope see galaxies that formed soon after the Big Bang, giving us a clearer picture of how the universe's structures developed. Since JWST is focused on infrared light, it can also study areas within galaxies where stars are being born, peering through the clouds of gas and dust that surround them. JWST has already provided amazing views of planets, moons, and other objects in our own solar system, offering fresh details about these familiar worlds. Its observations of gas giant planets, such as Jupiter and Saturn, and icy moons, like Europa, give scientists new insights into how our solar system formed and evolved over time. One of JWST's most exciting abilities is its study of exoplanets, planets that orbit stars outside our solar system. By looking at the light that filters through an exoplanet's atmosphere as it passes in front of its star, JWST can detect the chemical composition of that atmosphere. This information helps scientists figure out whether these planets might have environments that could support life, or at least conditions similar to those on Earth. As JWST continues its mission, it will help answer some of the biggest questions about the universe. From studying the smallest objects in our solar system to observing the most distant galaxies, this telescope will shed light on the complex processes that shape our universe. Each discovery brings us closer to a deeper understanding of how everything in the cosmos is connected. If Oumuamua is an alien spacecraft, what does that say about other interstellar objects whizzing through our solar system? Like and subscribe for our next deep dive into the mysteries of the universe.